Set, just all about making them feel better and giving them comfort. Bully breeds are going to be your Staffordshire Bull Terriers, your Pit Bulls, American Pit Bulls, Rottweilers, I can never say this right, Cane Corsos, Dagos, I think I said that right, probably wrong, and some German Shepherds can be considered as bully breeds and Dobermans.
I think it's because a lot of times the people who handle the bully breeds or who own them don't necessarily train them at all, or yeah, don't train them properly, so they become unruly or, you know, a danger to society just because they're not socialized well, and they sometimes are abused, and so they don't get that love and attention.
Judging, stereotyping, it's, you know, I find that I do the kind of the same thing where I stereotype people based off their looks. People do it with pit bulls, you know, Shepherd breeds, Rotties, you know, things like that. People definitely just see the dog and, you know, they judge them based on just those appearances alone without getting to know the actual animal. We do it to people as well.
My name is Kayla and I'm an exotic pet owner. I own a bearded dragon lizard named Sire, and they are a super popular breed as far as exotic pets go. But because I am black and lizards aren't a normal pet for people like me, I am judged as being weird, and I am constantly told that owning a lizard or an exotic pet is white people shit. My story is about my love for animals and how they are treated as different or scary. People like to judge things on how they look, but not the content of their character.
My name is Ben Graham, and I'm customer care representative. First animal was a dog named Nick, my favorite dog in the whole world. I love him. He's an English sheepdog, blue heeler mix, and I got him, I think I was like 3 years old, and I remember going down to the pound when it was still just basically looking like a jail, essentially, and looking through all the dogs, and he was just a little, I don't know how old he was, like a puppy, and I was like, Mom, I want that one. He's the one that's barking at me and everything like that. I have so many good memories with him. I grew up with him. I had him until I was 17 years old when he passed away.
My name is Lila O'Bain, and I am an investigations coordinator for Oregon Humane Society. Well, I did start out in the customer care department, helping with adoptions and answering phone calls just in general at the Humane Society, but I really had a passion for investigations and going out and helping animals that were abused or neglected, and it helped me to see that this was more than just about animals, it's also about people. We do a lot of engagement with other agencies such as DHS and Human Services just to get people help, so like kids or elderly people who might also be in a bad situation in a home where an animal's also being abused or neglected. So it's helped me see that side of it and see that it's helping people as well.
The hardest thing is seeing them come in hurt and not knowing how they got hurt, and then also trying to help them and they're really upset and won't let you. That is the hardest thing, just knowing that they're in that kind of pain and you can't make it better at that moment. It takes time.
Yes, so we do have a lot of livestock cases because we work throughout the state of Oregon, primarily in like the 5 or 6 counties that are surrounding Multnomah County, but we reach out and help other agencies further out if needed, because a lot of times in the rural areas, the agencies there are small and they don't have very many resources to deal with large cases that right. include any kind of pet, including livestock.
I think, I mean, non-traditional animals, I go for the exotic, so like sugar gliders are awesome.
Oh yeah.
And then chinchillas are awesome too. My first hamster I had, so, and her name was Ham Ham, by the way. And Ham Ham and I were just best friends, and we just hung out all the time.
So, as you can see, I have quite a few paw prints. Just my love of animals. All these paw prints are representative of the dogs that I've had in the past. Some of them are actual pictures of their paw prints. I don't know where I'd be in my life without all my dogs. So that was something that I kind of wanted to always have the reminder of for every dog that I've had and the impact that they've had on my life, and how they've kind of changed my life.
Yeah, I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more. I'm gonna take my horse to the old town road. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more.